So now students, next we proceed to what are the different types of built-in functions that are required for the tuple test. Maximum built-in functions that are required in list, exactly same built-in functions that are required in the tuple also. So here are the some of the examples are given, some of the built-in functions are given. One of the very important functions, that is CMP, that is compare. Compare the elements of both tuple. Okay, it will return either true or false. Remember that, it's a Boolean type. So after that you write the length tuple, because these are all linked or given, but I told you that alien function is checked to the length of the tuple. How many elements are to be present in the tuple, that can be checked using this alien function. Okay, after that you can use the max tuple. This is another inbuilt functions are there to check the maximum element from the tuple. But remember one thing, in this max function you are not able to store integer and as well as string value combined together. There should be only the integer value can be stored there. So remember that is the same concept to be applied for to find out the minimum value from the tuple. And last one is the tuple sequence. Okay, tuple sequence is actually very important function. This method is actually convert a list into a tuple. Suppose you can take a list and you want to convert this list into the tuple, you can use this method to convert that list into a tuple. Okay, some of the programming applications we have discussed about from this particular chapter. It is a very short span of time, so we will take its details about this chapter. Okay, what are the programming section area? Some of the question answer we discuss first within 1 minute. What is tuple? Tuple is a collection of Python objects separated by commas. Very simple. Are tuple mutable or immutable? Already I discussed about this is immutable, because there cannot be, you are not able to update, modify, or anything you are changed, able to change from this tuple area. Which type of elements are stored in tuple? You know that there can be stored any type of element, either by int, float, string, complex number, any type of element you can store inside of tuple. How to create an empty tuple? Very easy question. That is t equals to, suppose you can write tuple, it's a method. You know that after that if you can write print t, that means it will display a empty tuple. That means the tuple does not contain any value. What do you mean by a nested tuple? Suppose a tuple inside of this another tuple is there, then you can say that it's called a nested tuple. That means you are already learned about the concept of nested loop, nested for loop, right? Where one loop is the outer loop, another is the inner loop. Same concept to be applied in the nested tuple. What are the syntax to create a tuple from an existing sequence? Please check that. So new tuple underscore name, this is just a variable name, and after that you give the method name, that is a tuple. In this way you can create a simple tuple. Observe the output of the getting code. These are the questions are very important for class 11 and 12 standard. What are the questions? What is the output? There are near about 10 to 12 marks. It will come in the class 12 from the revision tool. One chapter you will learn in class 12. So observe the output of the given code. Suppose you can take a tuple. These are the tuple elements are to be there. So after that you write t2 equals to tuple of t. Tuple is the method or function that you can use. That means this tuple is actually, this list is actually converted to the tuple. Okay, what is the traversing tuple in Python? Traversing, I already show you. Traversing is a technique to access an individual element of the tuple. If you want to retrieve a specific information or specific data from the tuple, you can use the accessing method or traversing in a tuple. Last and final question, what is the use of less than equal to operator in tuple? You know that less than equals to is called the relational operator, right? Less than equals to, greater than equals to, not equals to, equals to, equals to. These are all relational operator. Equals to is the equality operator. This operator returns true only if the value of the left is either less than or equal to or in compared to the right hand side value. So rest of the programming section and the error checking section we will discuss about in my next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.